Hi, it's Weston Nye, and today we are looking at the Viltrox EF-2 RF Speedbooster. We use it on the Red Komodo to get that super awesome full frame look on the Super 35 sensor of the Red. So, Chance, can you get me the camera?
Yeah. Here you go.
No, that is not the right camera.
Sorry,
no.
Sorry. You meant the Red.
I meant the Red. You? Yeah, give me the Red.
Okay. Here you go.
No.
Oh, you meant the
Red Komodo.
You meant
yes.
The other.
Oh, there goes my phone.
I'm gonna see myself out.
Drop my phone. Okay. Red Komodo. There it is. The Viltrox Speedbooster. Looking good. All right, little disclaimer. Viltrox themselves did send me this little Speedbooster, and they are letting me keep it, but I'm still gonna give an honest review. So here's what the Speedbooster looks like. It's got all metal design, so it's very nice. Very impressed with the build quality of this thing. It's pretty heavy, so you know it's quality, but you know, the Red Komodo, it's all about being extra lightweight and portable, so just know you are adding a tiny bit of weight on here, but it's not that much. Now, why would you want a Speedbooster for your Komodo? Well, number one, the Reds are not known for having amazing low light performance like these Sonys, so you get an extra stop of light with a Speedbooster, and you get the full frame image circle from one of these full frame lenses projected and compressed down onto the little Super 35 sensor on here. So you're getting that full frame image circle and full frame light gathering capability put onto the Super 35. So you get that full frame look and all the benefits of full frame, like being able to take full advantage of the f1.8 that this 50mm is, or the f1.4 that this lens is. All of the f-stop and aperture numbers on these lenses are written in the full frame equivalents, and so on a full frame camera like the Sony's, this 50mm or my 55 or this Leica 50mm, when they're on the full frame Sony's, are true f1.4 and f1.8 and all those things. But when you put it on a small sensor like a Red, you don't get that full frame image on the sensor. Effectively, you are losing some of the light gathering capabilities and bokeh of your lens. So putting this Viltrox Speedbooster on there gives you a full frame image look. It gives you that little bit wider angle, so your wide angle lenses are wider on this thing, which is really useful in many cases. So yeah, that's why you want a Speedbooster, is to take full advantage of your full frame lenses and get more for your money out of this Red Komodo. Now, let's do some pros and cons of the thing. We've been testing this thing quite a lot. We've shot a short film with this, and we've shot lots of different little clips, and we'll show you some of those throughout the video, but we haven't really noticed any issues with sharpness or chromatic aberration any more than we would normally get from lens distortion. So we're very happy with the quality of this thing so far. So far it just looks really good, and there is no noticeable drop to the quality. And as you'll see, it has little communication points. You get to talk to the lens with this adapter. That's not something you get with super cheap adapters. So you can control aperture and see all that data. And you do get to take advantage of the Red Komodo's autofocus with the full frame 50mm Canon lens I've got on here and other lenses. Right now I have on here the full frame Canon 50mm STM lens, and we are checking the autofocus out. And it's working decently. It's definitely not anything good. It's really hunting there. I mean, it's not a lot of light going on right here. It's a pretty low light situation inside. But yeah, you can see autofocus does work, but the autofocus on the Komodo is not that good. I would never want to use the autofocus in a professional setting with the Red Komodo, at least not yet. It's still in beta, so maybe it will get better, but the autofocus on this thing is not that great. But the Viltrox Speedbooster does work. All the electronics work. Autofocus, aperture, all those good things work through the Viltrox. So no fault to the Viltrox. Mostly the Red Komodo just doesn't have good autofocus. And we have tested like the Sigma 18-35 lens on here. That's a Super 35 lens. We just put that directly on the Red, and the autofocus works on that too. Basically the same as this. So the Viltrox is not hurting your autofocus performance. It's just bad to start with. For the last pro for this Viltrox Speedbooster, I checked the price, and the price for this guy is $270. Now, that might sound a little expensive for an adapter, but this is way more than an adapter. This is an optical element, so it's a high quality piece of glass housed in a all metal construction, and it has pass-through pins so you get all the electronics through it. So there's way more to it than, say, this cheap little EF to Sony E adapter. And things get really good when you look at the competition. The official Canon EF to RF Speedbooster, so the one we would have gotten if we didn't get this, was $600. I don't know, at that price we might not have gotten it, but that's what we were looking at to get the full frame look on the red Komodo. $600 from Canon. That's pretty expensive, way more expensive than the Viltrox. And then the good old company Metabones, that's been making speed boosters for years, charge $480 for their version of this speed booster. So in the price department, the Viltrox is the clear winner. You get amazing performance. Everything's great about this thing. We really don't have any complaints. And you get it for a fraction of the price of the other ones that are just like it. If we were to do it all over again, we wouldn't buy the Canon, we wouldn't buy the Metabones, we would definitely buy the Viltrox. Quickly going back to build quality, we're going to go into the cons. This is not actually the fault of the speed booster, but you can see, and here, it's not a perfectly snug fit. It has a little bit of play and a little bit of wobble, but that's not the fault of the speed booster. That's more the fault of the red. The mount is not the tightest on this camera. The other red has a little locking screw, so it tightens down on there. So there's no wobble issue on that red, but this one doesn't have a tighten locking thing. I kind of wish it did, but I guess they're trying to keep it small. And the adapter that comes with the red so that you can put Canon EF lenses onto the red, which has an RF mount, it has the same amount of wiggle. So it's not the Viltrox's fault. And then the final con is there's a little bit of vignetting. The image circle that it projects off these full frame lenses onto the sensor is, I don't know, a little bit wider than full frame. And there is a tiny bit of vignetting on both sides. It hasn't really been an issue for us. It mostly shows up in extreme low light situations. But if you're cropping into widescreen for like a film or something, it's not gonna be that big of an issue. But yeah, that's a minor issue. And if it really drives you crazy, you can always crop in just a hair. It's a 6K sensor. Cropping down or shooting in 5K will completely make that vignetting problem go away. But then you are losing some of the benefits from the speed booster. So keep that in mind. There can be a tiny bit of vignetting, especially if it gets really dark where you're shooting. I tested out, I took my Sony A7 III here and pointed it out the window and shot a few seconds and then put the red in the same exact spot. And you can see the image off of the red is a little bit wider than the image off of the full frame Sony camera. This is the same lens, same settings, but the speed booster makes the image a little bit wider off the same lens. But that shouldn't be specific to the Viltrox because it's a 0.71x speed booster and the official Canon one is the same. That's basically the only con with this thing. Everything else was amazing. We really love this thing. We would definitely buy it if we didn't already have it. Thank you so much, Viltrox, for sending this to me. It's been super fun and we're gonna be using this for years to come as long as we have the red Komodo. All right, how am I gonna sign this off? My hat. I was really slow with this one. I got in a bad bike accident, hit my head. Not fun. Don't think my brain's working. It's not firing on all four cylinders right now. This
is it ever?
That was like, hey. Yeah, I've been recording for like 20 minutes now. All right, signing off with the Rome West hat. Make sure you check the link in the description if you want to buy your own Rome West hat or my prints, and I will see you next time.